With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello students, question is, each question contains statement 1, that is assertion, and statement 2, that is reason. Examine the statements carefully and mark the correct answer according to the instructions given below. So statement 1 is, for the reaction A gaseous going to B gaseous plus C, Kp is given 1 atmosphere. If we start with equal moles of all gases at 9 atmosphere of initial pressure, then at equilibrium partial pressure of A increases. And reason is given, statement 2, that is reaction quotient Qp is greater than Kp, hence equilibrium will shift in the backward direction. So in this question, two statements are given, one is assertion and the other is reason. We have to find the correct answer, that the assertion and reason are correct or not, and the reason is correct answer for the assertion or not. So the first is given, that for this reaction, that is A gaseous giving B gaseous plus C gaseous, and Kp for the reaction is given as 1 atmosphere. Now it is also given that if we start with equal number of moles, now say if we start with equal number of moles, let's say if we start with one moles of each of the gas, so the reaction quotient, it will be Qp is reaction quotient, that at any time if we find the Qp, that reaction quotient, which is equal to the concentration of products, or in the case of gases, this is partial pressure of products raised to power the stoichiometric coefficient divided by partial pressure of reactants raised to power their stoichiometric coefficient. Now the partial pressure would be, partial pressure is calculated as mole fraction into total pressure, that is P total. Now mole fraction is calculated as the number of moles of that species to the total number of moles. Now if we say the partial pressure of A gas will be the number of moles of, sorry, mole fraction of A into total pressure, mole fraction of A will be, the number of moles of A will be 1 and total moles will be 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3, into total pressure, initial pressure is given 9 atmosphere, Pt is given 9 atmosphere. So it will be this, it means this is equals to 3 atmosphere. Similarly, partial pressure of gas B would be its mole fraction. So mole fraction will be simple, number of moles of gas B upon total number of moles. This is its mole fraction into total pressure. So this will be similarly, that is 3 atmosphere. And similar for partial pressure of C, it is also, its mole fraction will be 1 by 3 into total pressure, that is 9 atmosphere. So its partial pressure would be 3 atmosphere. Now if we calculate the value of reaction quotient, that will be partial pressure of the products, that is partial pressure of B into partial pressure of C divided by partial pressure of A. So partial pressure of B is 3 atmosphere, partial pressure of C is also 3 and A is also 3. So this gives us Qp value is, that is reaction quotient value is 3 atmosphere, and Kp value, that is the equilibrium constant, it is given 1 atmosphere. It means the reaction quotient is greater than the equilibrium constant Kp. It means the reaction will move to backward direction. So if it will move to backward direction, then the concentration of the reactant will increase. Partial pressure will increase because there is gaseous state. So partial pressure of A will increase due to the reaction which is going to backward, because Qp value is greater than Kp, so backward reaction will be favored and partial pressure of A will increase. So this statement 1 is the, or assertion is the correct, and reason is given, reaction quotient value is Qp is greater than Kp, hence the equilibrium shifts in backward direction. So this is also true, because Qp value is greater than Kp, and equilibrium shifts in backward direction. Due to backward direction of the equilibrium, the partial pressure of A is increasing. So this is also correct and the correct explanation for statement 1. So the correct answer to this question is A, that both the statements are true, and statement 2 is the correct explanation for statement 1. I hope you understood the solution. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.